Good evening, everyone. My name is Dr. Saurabh Roy. I welcome you all in the lecture of Microwave Engineering. In the last lecture, we discussed about the two cavity klystrons. So in this process, we discussed about how velocity modulation takes place. So now, what are the effect of the velocity modulation? We'll see in this lecture and how the applicate diagram came. So first, the effect of the velocity modulation is called bunching process. So here electron beams are bunched together and it's moved from bunching cavity to the catcher cavity. Then we will calculate its output power as well as we will calculate its efficiency. So first we will revise all those things, just recap. Okay. So here two cavity klystron is there. So one is buncher cavity, another one is the catcher cavity. So RF input is given in the buncher cavity and we are taking the RF output from the catcher cavity. So in between buncher cavity and catcher cavity, the distance we are considering L distance. So here we will see the cathode is emitted some electron beams. Whenever those electron beam is passing through this buncher cavity, all the electron beams are bunched together. Okay. So that is called bunched electron beam. So that is the effect of the velocity modulation taking place. After that, those electron beam we are passing through the catcher cavity and we will collect it from its the RF output that is collected by using coupling mechanism. So now, what did the bunching process occurs and how bunching process is occurs at which distance we will calculate. So before going to the bunching process, because it is the effect of the velocity modulation, we will discuss in the last lecture. So first we will discuss the velocity modulation. Before going through the buncher cavity, the velocity of the electron v0 equal to root over 2e v0 divided by m, where m is the mass of the electron, e is the charge of the electron, and that is the velocity of the electron, and v0 is the applied DC voltage. So we are applying some voltage in the buncher cavity. So that is the average voltage is given through the buncher cavity. So due to the average voltage given to the buncher cavity, the velocity modulation is. So the modulated velocity Bt1 equal to V0 1 plus beta I B1 divided by 2 B0 sine omega T0 plus theta G by 2. So that is the velocity modulated. So the maximum value will occur when the value is become, sine value is become 1 and minimum value is 1 occur when this value is become minus 1. Okay. So maximum value will get B0 1 plus beta I B1 divided by 2 B0. And minimum value will get B0 1 minus beta I B1 divided by 2 B0. And same value will get whenever this part will become 0. So if this part is 0, then we will get Bt1 equal to B0. So three condition is come. One is greater than B0, one is less than B0, and one is exact B0. So due to this three condition, greater than and less than, the velocity modulation is taking place. So once the electron leave the buncher cavity, they drift with the velocity either increases, decreases or uniform. So all the electrons, some electron is passing through its greater velocity, some electron passing through its lesser velocity, some electron is same velocity. So after it, some instant of time, all the electron is making a bunch. Okay. So here we'll see that our diagram. So that is the bunching process, how bunching processes occurs. So some electron is moving with slower velocity. Already we discussed that at negative value of that BS voltage will get lesser velocity. That positive value when it is come will get the velocity is greater than B0, and when 0 will come, so that is 0 value. So BT1 already we will mention, so that is depend on B0 1 plus beta I B1 divided by 2 B0 into sine part. Okay. So sine part. So whenever this part is greater than B0 equal to or Bt1 equal to greater than B0, when this part will get positive value. So this part will get positive value. So from this, if faster, slower and same, all the electron after an instant of time, it reach this particular point that is called bunching center. So first we'll see the effect of velocity modulation produces bunching of the electron beam. So whenever Bs equal to 0, the electron will move with the same velocity. Whenever Bs is positive, the electron is moving with a faster velocity. And whenever Bs is negative, the electron is moving with a lesser velocity. So three conditions are there. One is electron is moving with the same. One is electron is a faster and one is electron is a lesser. So all the electron, whenever it is passing through faster, same and slower velocity, they are making a bunch point. Okay. So here we are considering only three electrons. One is this particular maximum point. It is bunching same type of same things we will get. So all the electron, whatever the electron, it will reach this particular point at some instant of time. We will consider that at TT time, all the electron is reach that bunching center and it will cover the distance is del of L. Okay. So del of L, it will cover all the distance. Now, we will calculate what time exactly the bunching is happened and we will also calculate the distance, that del of L. Okay. So first we will consider when velocity is 0, Bs equal to 0 or same velocity will reach B0 equal to that electron is moving with same velocity. Before entering the buncher cavity and after entering the buncher cavity, the velocity of the electron is same because Bs is 0. So we will get del L equal to B0 equal to Td minus Tb. So we know distance equal to velocity into time. So del L is the distance, that distance it is traveled equal to Td minus Tb time. Okay. So that is Td and that is Tb. So total del L equal to B0 into Td minus Tb, velocity into time. Similarly, for positive velocity or faster velocity, we will get del L equal to B max into Td minus Tc, as well as for lesser velocity, we will get del L equal to B min Td minus Ta. So three conditions we are reaching, one for same velocity, one for positive velocity, another one for negative velocity or lesser velocity. So whenever we'll try to all the things in the same point, okay? Then we'll calculate at what instant of time all the things will bunching will be at same. So first we'll place the value of Bmax. Bmax we already know the maximum velocity of the velocity modulated B0 into 1 plus beta I B1 divided by 2 B0. Similarly, B min equal to B0 equal to 1 minus beta I B1 divided by 2 B. So if we'll place the value Bmax in this and that particular equation, then we'll reach some three equation we'll reach. One, this equation already existed and these two equation already will come in these terms. Okay. Now we'll place. So first for maximum condition, we already know Bmax equal to Td minus Tc. So Bmax we can write Td minus Tb minus pi by 2 omega. Because whenever we will consider any signal, so we are considering this part only. Okay. So we already this positive max and this one negative max. So we are considering this Td will be there. So this one is Tb. So this part and this one is Tc. So Td minus Tc we are know. So these things we can Td minus Tb. So this whole distance minus this particular distance. So that is T by 4. So T by 4 also we can write, because if we will consider the whole signal is time period T, then this part will be T by 4. So T by 4 we can write in pi by 2 omega. How? Because pi by 2 omega, if we will mention omega, we know omega equal to 2 pi f. So pi is there, pi pi will cancel, 1 by 4 f. So 1 by 4 f equal to T by 4. So same things we are written there. So instead of So, Td minus Tb minus pi by 2 omega. Similarly, so we know Bmax value equal to B0 1 plus beta I B1 divided by 2 B0. So, if we'll place that Bmax value in there, so we'll reach that particular equation. So, how we'll reach? Instead of Bmax, we'll place this. So, B0 plus B0 Bi beta 1 divided by 2 V0 capital B0. So, if we'll place B0, B0 into Td minus Tb minus B0 minus pi by 2 omega, plus beta I B1 divided by 2 B0, B0 Td minus Tv, similarly this point. So similarly for minimum velocity, we will get Td minus Ta. So B min Td minus Tb plus pi by 2 omega. So if we will place the B min value in this particular equation, so we will get reach this particular solution where del L equal to B0 Td minus Tb plus this equation. So we will reach for faster value if velocity is higher, if velocity is lower. And if velocity of same, then we know del L equal to B0 TD minus TB. So we know del L equal to for B0 TD minus TB for same velocity. Okay. So three equation we should consider this equation one, equation number one. So equation number two for lesser velocity, and this one is equation number three. Okay. So all the value should be same, because del L distance, that particular point, all the value, that distance covering of all the electron should be same, then only it will reach that particular point, that is called bunching center. Okay. So if all the condition will be same, only when only this particular value will be zero. Okay. This particular value will be zero. And this particular value should be zero. Then only we will get this point, del L equal to B0 TD minus del L equal to B0 del L equal to B0 TD minus TB. So we will reach this particular solution, that all the three electrons are placed at a particular point or bunching point. So we should place this value is zero and this value should be zero. Then only it will reach that bunching center. So we are considering this value is zero as well as this value is zero. So if we'll consider this value is, both value is zero, then if we neglecting this term only minus positive or minus changes are there, both two equation. So if we'll place this term we neglected, then we'll find out that TD minus TV equal to, so this part equal to this part. So we'll get this TD minus TV equal to B0, we can cancel. So TD minus T equal to B0 pi divided by omega beta I B1. Okay. So that is the TD minus TB, and from this equation we will calculate the del L distance. So del L equal to B0 TD minus TB, that is B0 B capital 0 pi divided by omega beta I B1. Okay. So that is the time and that is the bunching distance. Okay. So all the electron will reach that particular point. Now we are considering only single things or single electron. So similarly the pattern will be like that. Okay. So there are some bunching electron, all the electron in this particular range, it will be bunches at that particular point. Again, another in this particular range, again there will be bunching. So that diagram is called applicate diagram. Okay. So again all the electrons will be bunches together in there. So that is one bunch, that is another bunch. Okay. So electrons are bunches. So that diagram is called applicate. Okay. So it comes under the velocity modulation process. Whenever the velocity modulation is taking place, due to that velocity modulation, bunching of electron is taking place. And due to that bunching of electron beam, we can draw the applicate diagram. So those are the two cavity klystron amplifier. Now we'll calculate its transit time. So transit time T equal to T2 minus T1. So that is the T1 time when it leaps from the buncher cavity, and T2 time when it is entering to the catcher cavity. So T2 minus T1, that is the DL. So T2 time equal to distance divided by velocity. So that is the modulated velocity of the electron beam. We already calculated L divided by BT1. So we'll place the value of BT1. So BT1 we know, B0 into 1 plus beta I B1 divided by 2 B0 sine omega T0 plus theta G by. So if we'll place this binary 1 plus, so we'll 1 plus x whole to the power minus 1, then we'll get 1 minus x. So here T0 equal to DC transit time, that T0 equal to DC transit time we can consider. In terms of radian angle also we can calculate that radian angle. So instead of T we'll placing omega T2 minus T, and we'll get, instead of T0 we'll get theta naught minus x sine omega T1 minus theta G by 2. So this we will consider T0 equal to omega L by B0 equal to DC transit angle between cavities. Okay. So one cavity is buncher cavity, another cavity is catcher cavity, and the time is reaches, that is called transit time T2 minus T1. Okay. So we are considering from L by BT1, then we will place the value of BT1, and this will come just 1 plus x whole to the power minus 1, you can consider 1 minus x. So from this equation we can reach T0 equal to, we can mention DC transit time. So in terms of radian angle also we can calculate, that will be omega T equal to omega T2 minus, so only in terms of T we will place theta. So where x equal to called bunching parameter of a klystron. So we'll get beta I v1 divided by 2 v0 theta naught. Same things only. So instead of beta I v I 2 v0 theta naught, we can consider that is called x. So that is the bunching parameter of a klystron. Now we'll see the current. So at a buncher gap, charge dq0 passing through at a time interval dq0 is given by so we not charge equal to current into time. Okay. So another conservation of charge, whatever the charge passing through the any part, same amount of charge will reach from that second. So where I0 we can consider DC current. So from that conservation of charge, same amount of charge dq0 also passes through the catcher at a later time interval d2. So hence we can consider equal time that charge will be equal according to the conservation of charges I0 dt0 equal to I2 d t2. So from this equation, so we know t2 value equal to t0 plus tau plus this one is t2 minus t1. Okay. So total time t2 minus t1, already we are considering transit time. So 3, how it will come? So t1 is there, then with that small gap that is for tau time is there. So t2, this one is t2 minus t1. So all the things will be added. So we'll get t2 equal to t0 plus tau plus t2 minus t1. So now we'll take derivation. So dt2 will get dt0 minus, this part is a constant, that's why we'll get 0. This one t naught also get constant, will get 0 and will reach this. Sin omega will become cos omega and dt. So from this equation we can write dt t2 equal to dt naught minus 1 minus x cos omega t naught plus theta g by 2. So in terms of I2 t naught, if we place this in earlier equation, we'll get I2 t naught equal to I naught divided by 1 minus cos omega t naught plus theta g by 2. So in terms of t2 time, if we'll take, then we'll get I0 divided by 1 minus x cos omega t2 minus theta naught minus theta g by 2. Now we'll take, we'll solve this particular equation. So we'll get the Fourier series, okay, in a periodic waveform of a period 2 pi by omega, the current I2 can be expanded in a Fourier series. So the expanded series will be I2 equal to A0 integration from n1 equal to infinity summation an cos n omega t2 plus bn sin n omega t2. So that is the summation where a0, an and bn are the coefficient of the Fourier series. So the coefficient can be, we will consider a0 equal to I0, the value of the coefficient an equal to 2 I0 jn nx cos n theta g plus n theta naught, bn equal to 2 I0 jn nx sin n theta g plus n theta. So if we place all those coefficient in this particular solution, then we'll get I2 equal to I0 plus summation of n equal to 1 to infinity 2 I0 Zn x nx cos n omega t t2 minus t minus t0. So how we'll reach this particular equation? So if we'll place the value of this an and bn, so cos a cos b plus sin a sin b, so we'll get cos a minus b. So from this equation, from this trigonometric transformation, we'll reach this particular solution. So the fundamental component IF has its maximum amplitude equal to 2 I0 J1X. The fundamental component we are considering n equal to 1. So its maximum amplitude value is this one. Okay. So X, if we'll reach this particular, that first kind of Bessel function, the X value, root value is 1.841. And from this equation, we'll calculate the optimum distance, that will 3.682 B0 B0 divided by omega beta I B1. So that distance, and earlier we already calculated del L. So there is small mismatch or small error is there, but that is the perfect one. We are calculated from its Bessel function. Okay. We are not neglecting that terms. Okay. So that is the current. So now we will calculate the output power, that is small things, as well as efficiency of the catcher cavity. So output, the induced current, we know that in the two cavity klystron amplifier, the collector part, the catcher cavity is, the current is induced. And we will calculate the output power or output part we can consider from the catcher cavity. So induced current will be I2 induced equal to beta naught I2. So that I2 already we calculated. Considering n equal to 1, we will get this particular part but the I naught part is DC current part is not considered. So I that beta part is the that induced current coefficient we can consider beta naught. So I2 N2 will get beta naught I2 B0 2 I0 Z1 X. So that part cos part will consider 1. So maximum value will be this part. So P out will be I square 2 divided by R shunt. Okay. So we will get beta naught I2 B2 by 2. So that is the output power from the catcher cavity. Now we will come if we will consider the efficiency. So efficiency term is the output power divided by input power. So P0 divided by P in. So P0 already we are considered P B0 I2 B2 by 2. And input is this one P input equal to I0. So, from this above equation, we can calculate the efficiency of the two cavity klystron amplifier. So, that is the whole things regarding two cavity klystron amplifier. So, we started from its different velocity modulation process. Then, we will go through the bunching process and as well as we calculated its power output, current as well as efficiency. Thank you.